working as an assistant professor of English at Anna University, Chennai, an avid learner interested in investigating ways to approach and handle classroom issues in teaching the English language. She has a PhD in English funded by University Grants Commission's NET Senior Research Fellowship, a master's in education, and she's the gold medalist. And she also has TESOL USA certifications in teaching English. Dr. Shobha has authored textbooks and workbooks with Cambridge University Press and Orient Black Swan for learners of English language at the tertiary level, in addition to several research articles. She has been a member of content development team of the Content and Language Integrated Learning Textbooks for the Tamil Nadu Textbook Corporation for Arts and Science Colleges and the ITI Textbooks of Employability Skills for the National Instructional Media Institute, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Dr. K.N. Shobha is also a trainer cum consultant for the Research Connect program of the British Council. She is the chief consultant and resource person for the State Council of Educational Research and Training for the state of Andhra Pradesh and has developed textbooks at the primary level. She is also of the strong conviction that the 21st century skills of communication, critical thinking, creativity, and collaboration are vital to both learners and teachers of the English language because English opens doors. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to welcome you, ma'am, on behalf of our department.
Thank you so much. So it's a very wonderful afternoon, and I'm very happy to address all the students of SRM campus, Ramapuram campus especially. So there are so many things that you can be doing on a Saturday afternoon. You can be watching a good movie on Netflix. You can be playing online games with your friends, or you can rather have a good short nap or a siesta, as they call it. But seeing your enthusiasm to attend a webinar, you know, to learn how you can master your language skills in order to enhance your employability skills, I'm really glad to be addressing you. That was a long introduction made by Sylvia, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, for all the kind words. And I also thank the HOD of the department, you know, who have also welcomed me and given me an opportunity to be here and address you all. As your HOD rightly pointed out, everybody is thinking about what will happen to their jobs because of the crisis. I am sure you would have heard about so many people who have been endangered of their jobs. You would have heard from family and friends how somebody lost their job, or how somebody is really unsure whether their manager is going to call them or not. So there is a lot of apprehension, anxiety in the minds of people around us. So how are we going to cope with this kind of a crisis situation? To be very frank, I've been in this particular field of English language learning and teaching for the past 15 years. And I have seen that this is one field where the doors are always open for us. If it was a normal routine kind of a college day, I would go to my class, finish my online classes, and I would accept weekly once or twice maybe to address students or give a lecture. But because of the online platform, I finish my online classes for my students, and then I'm able to meet huge number of participants, students, teachers, corporate people who want to get trained. So when I'm seeing how much of opportunity this has opened, I'm really amazed. And when people are telling me, I really don't know how to use this time, sometimes I feel very sorry for them because they don't know how to use this time productively. When you have taken up this particular language, you know, I understand most of you are students of BA and MA English department, and also some plus two students, Kavita ma'am was telling me. So this is a wonderful opportunity for us where we can develop our language skills and how we can relate it to our own employability, so that whenever there is an opportunity, we can avail it and make use of it properly. So I have prepared a presentation for you. I will be sharing it. Before that, some basic housekeeping rules. Please do not unmute yourself unnecessarily so that the lecture is not disturbed in between. And this is going to be a very interactive session in the sense that I will be using a bit of multimedia. There will be some audio, video, which will be played in between. And I also expect you to use the chat box whenever requested. In order to ask your questions, feel free to ask any kind of questions you have. Put that in the chat box so that by the end of the session, we would look at all the questions. My presentation will be for 1 hour. So these are the basic rules that we will keep in mind. I'm trying to share my screen now. I hope you are able to see the screen now. Kavita, are you able to see the screen?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, we are. We are able to see. Yes.
Okay. So, as you can see, the first slide, it says English opens doors. You must be wondering what kind of doors English will open to you. I'm talking about the English language here, which when you're mastering, there will be so many doors of opportunities. When you are trying to network with people, when somebody knows that you're very good in your language skill, you can start doing a number of things. So here you can see students just like you, who are sitting, who are trying to learn. There are so many books. They are waiting for their degrees. And one person is just sitting calm. So this is the scenario that all of you are in today. So this is my name. I'm an assistant professor of English from Anna University, Chennai. Let me just run through the table of contents for today. This will be the topics that we will be covering. The first topic I want to cover is why focus on English language skills? What is necessary? Why is it so necessary to focus on your language skills? And what is the importance of vocabulary? So when we talk about vocabulary, how does vocabulary impact our communication? And what are some of the ways that we can develop it? If you have the right words, you can communicate, you can articulate yourself very well. Because they say the difference between the right word and the almost right word is like the difference between a lightning and a lightning bug. You know what a lightning bug is? It's a small firefly. So if you're searching for the right word, if you're using the right word, the impact is going to be like the lightning. But if you're going to use the almost right word, it is going to be like a small firefly. That is why I always stress on vocabulary. And the third topic, the third part of it will cover a bit on LSRW skills, the listening, speaking, reading and writing skills. And then I will connect all this to your employability quotient. So all of you know about IQ, your intelligence quotient, several cues have come up now. So employability quotient is a very important idea. And then some tips to enhance your language skills during the lockdown. So how can you actually use this period very usefully? So I'm going to cover all these topics. First one, why do you want to enhance your English skills? Just think about it. Only because you are interested, you are here. Think about why you want to enhance your English language skills. Just type in the chat box, a couple of answers. in 2-3 words maybe. So you can type your answers in the chat box. I'm just opening the chat box and seeing. To get a job, Ashwini B. Bang on. That's the upfront answer, a very direct answer. To get a job, excellent. Any other answers? There are more than 20 people here. Okay, Judith says to present yourself good in interviews. Wonderful. That is one of the most important, opportunities that you can get in your life. To create a first impression in an interview. You know, they say you never get a second chance to create a first impression. You can create first impression only once. So Judith says to present yourself good in interview. I'm expecting some more answers because it's an afternoon and we better be interactive. So let us see how many more are answering. Definitely to get a job, definitely to present yourself better in an interview. Communicate effectively, obviously. You don't want to kind of mutter something in a very slow manner, or all of us want to communicate fluently, right? So whenever we talk about communication, we always speak about fluency. So if you want to speak fluently, if you want to communicate effectively, what are some of the things? That is why I just, in the beginning itself, I emphasized on the importance of vocabulary. Okay. So these are some of the answers that we have got. Let us go back to our presentation. Obviously, to get a job, to make a good impression in an interview, and to communicate effectively, we have to enhance our English skills. I always remember this quotation. You know, when Goethe says, the limits of my language are the limits of my universe. Only depending on how much you are able to express and think in a particular language, your limit of the universe will also be created. See, nobody used the word quarantine so much, right? So there are different pronunciations of the word, but the right pronunciation is quarantine. But today we are using the word quarantine so much, right? And that is a very kind of a limiting word. We also talk about social distancing. Sometimes I used to think whether social distancing is correct or should we simply have physical distancing? Because the word social has more implications. It relates to the psychology of human beings. It relates to our community type of living. Okay, so you can see how certain words can change the way we think. You must have recently heard about how a very popular brand of fairness cream of the Hindustan Unilever company has decided to drop the first word. All of you know about the Fair and Lovely company, and they said we have to remove this word because now you all know what is happening in the US and so many countries abroad, where the skin color is determining discrimination and creating a lot of crimes. So we think that language, words, these are not big things, but actually they are. The limits of your language are going to be the limits of your universe. If you are able to break the limits, if you are able to have a very big boundary, if you are able to put so many words inside, then that will be breaking the limit of your universe. You can expand like anything. You're all BA and MA students now. Now maybe you know only your college. You know some people who are working, your teachers. But then even without your knowledge, there is a big world waiting for you. And if you want to express your wishes, if you want to express your knowledge, you have to expand your language also, especially the English language. So always keep this in mind. And language also shapes human thinking. So some of you gave the reasons. First of all, you need to understand that English is a global language. Of course, all of us know this, right? English is a global language, and there are more than 50 countries in the world which has English as the official language. And Learning English also leads to social mobility. What do I mean when I say it leads to social mobility? I will be sharing, you know, my own experiences in a short while. But social mobility in the sense, you know, meaning how you move from one level to the next level. You would have heard stories from your grandfathers and grandmothers, you know, how they used to say, my father used to be very poor, then I started working, then I got this job, only then we bought this house, then your parents were born. You would have heard these kind of stories, right? So that is called social mobility. How you grow from a very lower strata to a higher strata in the society. Just because you get a job, just because you're able to read, the importance of education. All of you know that education is the only weapon which can change the world, in the words of Nelson Mandela, if you remember, right? So always remember that learning a language very well also leads to upper social mobility, upward and upper social mobility. So please remember this, especially this language. And because you're BA and MA students, I'm telling you that you are in a very important, you know, course. You are in a discipline that can give opportunities to other disciplines also. I will tell you how. So why focus on English language skills? If you remember, this is the first part. This is the first topic of the five topics that I showed you. It is obviously the language of science, technology, and internet. So if you want to find out anything in the internet, if you want to book a ticket, if you want to transfer money, of course, we have not been booking tickets at all for the past 2-3 months. We are so used to booking movie tickets, train tickets, bus tickets, but now everything is closed. And look at the second point. I hope you will agree with me when I tell you India is a multilingual country. The moment you step out of our state, it becomes extremely difficult to communicate if you cannot communicate effectively in English. So English has become a bonding language, not only outside India, but also within India. When you go to Andhra, you suddenly cannot speak in Telugu. When you go to Karnataka or, you know, Kerala, you cannot keep switching languages. But if you know English, if you're able to communicate well, it can take you to places. And English also means employability. You would have heard stories of how in interviews, though people have very good marks, just because of their communication problems, their placements are simply not happening. So even though you have good grades in other languages, even in English literature, just because we have an MA in English literature does not mean that we will get a job, right? So it takes a certain sense of dedication and practice to enhance your language skills so that your employability can also be improved. And obviously, it is the language of international communication, and it is also the language of business. So if you want to start any business or join any business, they are definitely going to look at your English language skills. So if you ask me, how do we gather all these skills? You know, you might be thinking, if you have money, if you go to a good coaching center, you can learn everything. No, that cannot happen. If you read certain books and memorize them, your language skill will improve. No, that is also not the case. So first of all, you must feel motivated. You know, a very high level of motivation is required if you want to master and practice the language skills. So only motivation can take you higher. So here, as you can see, I am wishing to, you know, share some of the paths or some of the milestones in my life, my own life, which has brought me here today. And I thought that, you know, because when Kavita said BA and MA English students, I was just taken back to my own college days. I know how you must be feeling now. Most of you must be thinking, okay, so next, what do I do? Should I do my MPhil and PhD? Or should I go take up some kind of a part-time job? Should I do some content developing? Okay, so many questions must be there in your mind. So most of you, I'm sure, must be preparing for your UGC NET exams, right? So I studied in a very ordinary government arts college in Chennai. And then I did my MA and MPhil in the University of Madras. Okay, so during my MA, I was able to clear the UGC NET exam. Because MA is the time when you're still very fresh in your mind. You know, all the subjects that you learn, everything that you learn is very fresh. So when people tell me they are writing the NET exam after 5 or 6 years after their MA, I used to think maybe they are doing a mistake. So all of you here must be motivated to try and complete these exams. And you also know that completing the exams is alone not enough. If you can get a fellowship, imagine your life will be settled. So there is this junior research fellowship which comes for the top rankers of the UGC NET. So you have to try and aim for it. You know that the portions are again from Chaucer to the contemporary literature. So spend your time reading more and more on that. Okay, so your language skills also will automatically improve. At least you guys have so much of internet today. You can download books wherever you want from. You can watch so many videos. But I still remember during my MA, which was 2002 to 2004, I used to carry a small floppy disk and go to an internet cafe. All the time that we had, you know, I think your HOD ma'am also will agree with me. We've had similar experiences. We used to go to these NET centers to download material to see what internet is, right? And then, of course, I have my PhD in English from the University of Madras. So I completed my PhD in 3 years. And then I also worked in a private college between 2010 and 14, after which I joined the Anna University in 2014. After that, you know, even before I left the college, I had joined my MA in education in IGNOU. You know that Indira Gandhi National Open University, you know, it offers correspondence courses. Because I had a full-time job, I couldn't take up any extra learning. But then I joined my MA in education in correspondence. So because I was already teaching, I understood the concepts of education very well. And whenever I teach students, I always used to think I should learn more so that I can teach them very well. That is why I joined my MA in education. And I took it quite seriously and I studied. So obviously you can see there is also this gold medal on the slide. And after that, what happened? So you can see now is 2020, 2016. So within a span of 3 to 4 years, I had also completed several online courses. Because I think learning should never stop. Believe me, it is only because of these things that I have done, I am what I am today. If I had not done any of these things, my life would have taken a different turn. So now you are only in your BA and MA, you still have a lot of time to think about what should be done, how you can support your parents, how you can support your homes, and first of all, how you can support yourself as human beings, right? Because now it is really a testing time for colleges, for students, for teachers. So self-learning is the only method. Whatever teachers are teaching us, we have to follow it. And we also have to look for extra references. So we are moving on to the next section now. We are going to understand what is the importance of vocabulary. So vocabulary is something I have always been interested in. I always believe that once you know the right words to say at the right place when you're talking, you create a very good impression. Most of the times we keep repeating words. Now say for example, Indians are used to this word nice. If I'm asking you, how is the food? Nice. How is the weather? Nice. So we have this problem of using the same word in many places. So in case you want to use different words, you have to improve your vocabulary and you have to realize the importance of vocabulary for that. So let us see how we can try and do that. You need to know more words so that you can sound smarter, you can communicate your thoughts exactly, and you can speak fluently. Also build up an impressive personality, right? When Obama speaks, all of us are looking like, you know, we are all awestruck. We are all dumbfounded and we want to listen to him. When Shashi Tharoor speaks, all of us ask him questions whether he is memorizing the dictionary every day. Because when you have the right words to speak, you know, they say that if you are at the right time in the right place, your life will change. Similarly, if you have the right words in your mouth, I think your life can also change for the good. This is why you should know more words, okay? To sound smarter, to communicate your thoughts exactly, to speak fluently, and to have a very impressive personality. And also look at this. Professional success actually depends on your communication skills. Look at the vocabulary test score. You can see how the floor bosses, who are the floor bosses? Now, if you go to supermarkets and other places, you will see somebody there managing, right? He or she is called the floor boss. Foremen, people who work in factories, manufacturing, superintendents, those who take care of him, then managers, upper level. Can you see how their vocabulary is increasing as they, you know, go higher in life? So presidents and vice presidents, if you look at their vocabulary test score, it is very high. So it is proportional, your professional success and your vocabulary. This is exactly why I keep telling people to improve their vocabulary so that they can speak well. Because they say, if you don't know grammar, you can express something. There is this joke. Okay, I remember because I used to share it with my students usually. All of you would have traveled in bus and you know that the conductor comes and he simply says tickets, 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 right? Does he say a full sentence? If he's saying ticket, 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 you understand that you are supposed to buy a ticket from him. He is not saying that, you know, tickets are available, please buy tickets. He doesn't say all that. Just by that one word, you understand. If he's going to say buy, 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 will you understand? No. So he knows that the right word is ticket. So most of the times, you have to understand that the right word can create magic. So keep this in mind, your good vocabulary can lead to good job. Now, how to improve vocabulary skills? Learn at least 3 new words every day. Every day there is so much of exposure when it comes to the mobile phone, internet, newspapers. Tell yourself, I will learn at least 3 new words today. All these things your teachers would have told you already, but most of the time when our parents say something, we don't understand its value. Only when some outsider says, we will think, okay, it is a big deal. Okay, so you have to learn at least 3 new words. MA and BA English students must learn at least 30 words. Learn ready-made phrases. What do I mean by learn ready-made phrases? There is something called formulaic expressions. Now say, for example, if somebody is asking you, how do you do? What will be your answer? You cannot say, I am doing fine. You have to say, how do you do? So how are you? You will say, I am doing good. I am great. You will say these things. But then there are so many ready-made phrases that we can use in life. These are called as multi-words or chunks, phrases. In the mobile phone, there are so many games. Guess what is the phrase? Guess what is the saying? Try and download these kind of games and play. There is also something called as Rebus, R-E-B-U-S. These games you can keep playing because playway method works well for you people, right? Gamification. So instead of playing all these, of course, you also have to play other kind of games now that you cannot go out. But you can try all these kind of language games also. And the last part is the most important part. You have to use it, otherwise you are going to lose it. What do I mean? When you have learned a new word, you have to at once use it. Now, say for example, let us take the word impeccable. Impeccable means exactly without any mistake, something that is very accurate. So you have to use the word. Now, say for example, you meet somebody, you can simply say, oh, that's an impeccable shirt that you're wearing. So something that is, you know, perfect for that particular day. Oh, your pronunciation is impeccable. So if you use the word in that day, they say that, you know, it sticks inside your head. Otherwise, you are going to lose it. I'm going to give you this method, which is called the etymology method. I'm sure your teachers also would have discussed with you. Learning the meaning of words through root words. So all of us know that philosophy. What is the meaning of philosophy? There are so many meanings. But then let us look at the word roots. So phil actually means love. You would have studied in your plus two hydrophilia, hygrophilia, all these things. But then Sophia refers to the goddess of wisdom. So philosophy refers to the love of wisdom. Then you also have something called philanthropist. Now, can you see the same phil is repeated here? So philanthropist, love, anthropist, anthropology, human beings. So name some philanthropists. You know that Bill Gates, Mother Teresa, all these people loved other human beings. And then misanthropist, somebody who hates. Can you see how, if you know the roots of the words, you can link and understand the other words also? Misogynist, somebody who hates. What is this G-Y-N? Gynecologist, gynecium. Something that is related to the female. So this is one method that you can use. So all of us are looking forward to hearing whether, you know, there is a vaccine for the present corona. So if you look at the word vaccine, it is coming from Greek, from Latin, especially from the Latin vaccina, which means cow. Okay. So when you understand the root of the word, it becomes very easy to remember the meaning of the word. So now all of us know that when we use the word geo, it refers to earth. Of course, geo also means so many other things to you. So geology refers to the physical or solid earth. That is how the name comes. So geologist, geography, all this you know. Look at, interestingly, the name George. So George is a very common name. Even among our participants, there might be some Georges. So George actually comes from the word for earth, which means the Greek word farmer. So somebody who works in the earth. So when I told this in my class, my students were saying, especially the boys whose names were Georges, they standard and they said, ma'am, I never knew that this is the meaning of my word. Okay. So George is again coming from the earth. So this is just one small example. This is just the tip of the iceberg. There are so many other word roots that if you understand, the comprehension of word meanings become extremely easy and you can keep developing your vocabulary. So I'm recommending this particular book to you. This book, which is called Word Power Made Easy by Norman Lewis. This was my Bible when I did my BA. The book is still available online also. Free copies are available, PDFs. One recommendation that I will have for you is download this book. Start working on it. It is a workbook type where you can write answers also. Every day tell yourself, I will finish 20 pages. I will finish 30 pages. Believe me, your vocabulary will increase like anything. And if your vocabulary increases, your communication in English will also improve. And this will lead to better opportunities in life. You can see how there are some 5 bullet points at the end of this book. Speak and write with confidence. Read more effectively and efficiently. Learn quickly. Develop social contacts. Increase your earning power. So you must be wondering, how is this earning power connected to speak and write with confidence? You can actually trust me. So all these things are connected. When you develop social contacts, what happens? People keep calling you for various other work also, right? So people call me for writing some articles. They call me to conduct webinars like this. They want me to develop some content for books. So there are so many social contacts with whom we can develop, right? So I recommend that you download and use this book very effectively, especially at least, in this lockdown period. So most of you know, then you will ask me, how do I go and download? These are all some links that you can use if you want to download. I always use the first one, very reliable. It has lots of books even released in 2020. So you can go to these sites and start downloading. So let us move on to the next section now, which is LSRW, listening, speaking, reading, and writing. So most of us know that language skills are LSRW, but then there are very important sub skills like grammar, vocabulary, pronunciation, the non-verbal skills also. So definitely we need also to focus more on these skills, pronunciation, non-verbal also. These are all called as sub skills. There is one thing about listening I usually tell my students, because they think that listening is equal to hearing. Hearing is something that happens involuntarily. There is no effort, but listening takes a lot of effort. Like what you're all doing now, you're trying to keep your ears open and listen. Now, this is actually the Chinese symbol for the word listen. You know that the Chinese language has only pictorial scripts, right? So this particular script is a combination of four other symbols. Can you see what the symbols are? The red one is actually denoting ears, to hear. And then you have something called mind. And then you have eyes. And then you have heart. So when you're listening to something, you will have to put all these things together and you will have to listen. Only then listening takes place. Also, 21st century skills are important. You have something called communication, critical thinking, creativity, and collaboration. So these skills are also important. I'm sure your teachers would have already told you about that. I also request you to understand more on this. Now let us move on to English and the employability quotient. So there are a lot of competitive exams that you can take right after you finish your BA. So definitely to get a job, like that was the first answer. Our Ashwini, she wrote to get a job. So there are all these exams that you can take in which English is a compulsory paper. So you might have good general knowledge, you might have good quantitative aptitude, but then you can also try these exams with good language skills. Sometimes to get a qualification also, we write a competitive exam, like the UGC NET exam I told you about, the BEC exam, the Business English Certificate, the BULATS, to fulfill a dream. So how many of you are planning to write the civil service exams, Union Public Service Commission exams? Even then, language skills are extremely important. So most of you must also be planning to write your TOEFL or GRE, IELTS, these kinds of exams, right? So you know that even to write these kinds of exams, it's very important. The graduate record examination and international English language testing system. These exams can also lead us to a higher path. So the language and competitive exams, if you see, it is very specific depending on the exam. Broad and deep language skills are tested. Regular and consistent preparation is required. And it also uses a variety of sources. It also requests, it also demands from you a lot of practice and discussion. So let us go to the last section now. Tips to enhance your language skills during the present lockdown. Here I will also cover about employability. Plan your day. Prepare a consistent schedule. Don't think you can master a language quickly. You have to listen to podcasts regularly. That is one example that I'm giving. I use this podcast very often, which is called The Blinkist. And watch a lot of TED Talks and speeches on YouTube. Follow a web series without subtitles. You know, this is my favorite, Mind Your Language. I hope you have also seen it. So how to watch a TV series. Most of you must be watching Friends, Big Bang Theory, right? These are the ones that my students watch a lot. Riverdale, my sons watch that. So these are all some of the things that you can watch. Now, why should you watch something related to language? Then there will be a lot of improvement in the way you're speaking. Of course, watching movies is important, because if you watch the right kind of movie, now on the screen, I have My Fair Lady for you. So My Fair Lady is a movie which talks about English language pronunciation. You can improve a lot of your pronunciation. So I will try and show you a small clipping from this particular movie. I hope you are able to see it.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Is it audible?
Yes, ma'am, it's not audible now.
It's not audible? Okay. So that was just a small excerpt. I hope that you should be able to see the movie. The full movie is also available on YouTube. So why I am asking you to watch this movie is, when we were in our MA days, you know, when we used to do theater, acting, foot plays, all these things, our pronunciation used to be corrected. Even the word pronunciation, many of them will say pronunciation, right? So it is important that we focus on short sentences, a variety of sounds, rhythm, intonation. So this whole movie is about the way you speak English. So I strongly recommend that you also watch this movie when you get the time. And of course, TED Talks, I've already mentioned. What you can do is you can download this transcript of the talk, read it out aloud and record. Then you can listen and compare, you know, how they are speaking and how you are speaking. That is one way of getting that kind of neutral accent. Of course, this is Sugata Mitra, the great professor who introduced the hole in the wall experiment. You would have known about him. Listen to Indians. We are not saying you should get British and American accents. Listen to Indians, but then you can do this. Now you have mobile phones in which this facility is available. Of course, you know, songs are a great way to learn. Most of you must be listening to, say, for example, Alan Walker or, you know, Imagine Dragons. Those are the names I keep, Justin Bieber. So you can try and keep singing aloud so that the pronunciation becomes impeccable. So, you know, these are just some lyrics that I copied so that in case if you're interested, you can try and learn. The song is also available on YouTube. Okay, now this is something very interesting. There are a lot of podcasts that are available. What are these podcasts and audiobooks? Most of you must have known this. They cover a wide range of topics. They have very clear voice and pronunciation. If you can listen it over and over and also repeat after it if necessary, your language will become very good. this is something that I keep using. BM English speaking, podcast that I listen to. Lots of excellent ideas are discussed in this podcast. It is free of cost. Okay, so I also recommend that you use podcasts. You listen to a lot of podcasts. In fact, I have one recording now. Let us see if you are able to listen to it. Kavita, just let me know if it is audible.
You are listening to episode number 200 of Audible. Today's word is revert. The word revert means to go back to a previous condition, state, practice or topic. It also means to reply or respond to someone. With BM English Speaking Radio Channel, learn one new word every day and impress the world. In this English vocabulary lesson, you will learn how to use the word revert. We are sure that this ESL lesson will help you to enhance your English vocabulary and speak English fluently and confidently. Revert is spelled as R-E-V-E-R-T. The word revert is used in a situation when a person or organization or a situation goes back to an earlier condition or method. It is also used when someone responds to a request or a query. For example, when the parents protested about the change in school timetable, the school decided to revert to the earlier schedule. The manager informed the customer that he will revert with more detailed information about the status of dispatches in a week's time. Listen carefully how we can use the word revert in 8 different situations in 8 different sentences. Example number 1 of 8. The railways received complaints about the poor screen visibility of the newly installed train indicator.
Okay. I'm just turning it off. So you can see how these are small bite-sized, audio clips for 5 minutes, and they cover a lot of interesting topics. So every day if you are going to listen to it, I am sure that the way you speak, the way you pronounce will also change and your communication will become very effective. So, to increase your employability, it is very important that you have lots of knowledge about your own field. So, there are lots of free online courses that are available which you must be doing, like say for example, MOOCs. Now, these are some MOOCs that I will recommend to you. English for the workplace, and all these are free courses. Please understand that you will also get a certificate. Exploring English language and culture. If you just type this MOOC and find out, you will get all the information related to it. Now these days, people are actually asking for these kinds of certificates also. So you can try and appear for these MOOCs. So MOOC certificates also increase your academic and employability credentials. Now you can understand that online learning is here to stay. Whether colleges reopen or not, whether you keep going to college or not, definitely there is going to be a blended way of learning. In that blended way of learning, it is important to understand that you are able to learn online and also teach online. That is why you must first understand the experience by attending these kinds of courses. That is one recommendation I will have. Now, coming to English for career itself, one of the biggest opportunity that is available is teaching English. You wouldn't believe me. I have received so many requests right from children who keep telling me, can you please come and do home tuitions? There is a big demand for teachers who can come home and do home tuitions, especially in spoken English for children. So teaching English is a very big industry. It is also becoming online now, right? So now you can see how I am discussing ideas with you. Like that, you can also teach a lot of online courses without moving from your place, and that can be one great career. The next one is journalism. you can start writing good articles, and when you write these articles, you will also be paid, right? Content developing. Imagine who is writing all these ideas on Flipkart and Amazon, product describing. All these content are also developed by people like you, right? Freelancers. You know, when I was doing my MA, I used to work for a publishing house correcting third standard and fourth standard textbooks. So when you're doing an MA, a third standard and fourth standard textbook is not a very difficult thing to go through and editing. Right? They used to give me 1,000 rupees per textbook. So every textbook will be some 80 pages or 100 pages. So in 2002 and 2004, you know the value of the money, right? So you can try and understand these kind of editing jobs also. Content developing, like I told you now. Media. When it comes to media, they are looking for people who can anchor well, who can speak well. Many of our students at Anna University, if you see, they have gone into media. You know, they are news anchors. They would have studied something else, but just because they can speak very good English, they get into that particular job. Technical writers. Like I told you, writing an instruction manual. These days, when you are buying a mobile phone, if you want to look at all the instruction manual, they don't give you books. They simply give it on the website itself. So somebody has to sit and write all that. Even that content developing, you have to do as technical writers. Like I told you, freelancing, online teaching and tuition. What is freelancing? You don't actually go there and work every day, but then you just sit in your house and you work at your own time, whenever you know it is comfortable and convenient for you. So these are all some of the things that you should be remembering when it comes to considering English for career. So always remember that one language sets you in a corridor for life. So there is only one language which will set you, like, you know, which will open the door and you go inside. But definitely you need to reach the other side, right? It is not the dead end. You need another place where there is another opening so that you can come out of it. So two languages you have to know, your mother tongue and definitely English. If you learn a foreign language, all the more opportunities you have. Like your HOD was saying in the beginning, how they also offer German, Japanese, French. Now, when you learn these languages, you can actually go to Japan and teach English there. So also learn another language. I recently completed my entry. So Japanese is such a nice language to learn. So when I learn these languages, you know, because I already have enough, you know, adequate knowledge in English to teach basic English there. That is one area I am planning to explore. Maybe online, maybe research. So please remember all these things. I hope we have covered most of it. Now, I thank you all for listening very patiently. So as planned, we have concluded the session by 3 o'clock. Now I am ready to take questions. If there are any questions, please type them in the chat box. I'm looking at the chat box. Thank you for the wonderful session. Please feel free to post your questions. So I hope many of you are also planning to, you know, do your UGC NET exams, become professors in colleges, work for a lot of other companies also. If you have any observation or feedback or any question, doubts, you can ask.
Kavita, no questions from the attendees?
Yes, ma'am. Ashwini has asked. Shobha, ma'am, Ashwini has asked something.
What is the question?
How to remember the words and use it in a correct situation, ma'am.
Okay, how to remember the words and use it in a correct situation. That is why I told you, when you are learning the words itself, you would have learned it in a particular context, right? So when that particular context you are facing again, you remember and you use that word, or you listen carefully. I told you about active listening, right? So you listen how people are using it in that particular context, and we will have to do that. When you do it once or twice, it will look very artificial, but then when you're using it, it will become part of your vocabulary.
Any other questions? I hope Rama ma'am shall
Yes, if there are no questions, probably we can, and if they send us anything, we can possibly forward it to Shobha, ma'am.
Definitely.
Yes, ma'am, definitely.
Sharon is asking some questions.
What's the question, Sharon?
Kavita, I always have this problem. I have a sentence in my mind to speak, but when I'm trying to speak, I stammer a lot, even though I am trying hard to make sure I'm speaking correctly. See, all of us have undergone this experience, Sharon, not just you, okay? So whether you are like, you know, a BA student or MA student, yes, when you are meeting BA student, definitely you will have that kind of fear. But remember that that is how we all learned. If we thought that somebody is going to make fun of us or whether we will make a mistake, we will never say the sentence, right? You know very well that English is not my mother tongue. But then, only because of constant practice, we also became what we are today. So whether you are, you know, thinking about a sentence, whether you have the sentence in mind, you just have to say it. After all, they are all your friends. They are not going to, you know, find fault with that, because they will also make mistakes while speaking. So communication, the purpose, the message, that should be the focus. Okay? It increases lots of confidence in you.
One more question
has come. Okay, thinking in mother tongue and converting in English, throw light on that. Actually, I don't understand, you know, this thinking in mother tongue and converting in English, because like I told you, the experience of my learning Japanese. So when I started learning Japanese, even my teachers used to say, when you enter the classroom, you have to think only in Japanese. You know, when I'm saying something, you have to think your reply that way, and then you have to answer. I have also tried that, because only if you are thinking like that, you will be able to, you know, generate that language. Now, I learned Japanese, I started learning Japanese when I was like 38. So they say that critical acquisition, language learning theory, critical hypothesis, everything says that between 7 and 12, lot of language learning happens. Now, English is not new to you, right? That language has been there since the time you were born. You're listening to a lot of English words. But this thinking in mother tongue and translating is not going to work. When you are going to speak in that language, you start thinking small phrases, words in that language itself, and then you speak. That is how it works. Okay, Ashwini, you first try, and whatever works best for you, you adopt that method. Just because somebody is recommending, we cannot change our perspective. Okay.
Yes. Okay, let me start, Mama.
Yes, Kavita. Just before that, just a word to Dr. Shobha, and somebody is asking Sharon is asking again.
Any tips for that? Okay.
So you say you are a writer. You write books, articles, and short stories. Very nice to hear that, because you know writing is not an easy skill. I strongly recommend, you know, there are a lot of writing apps now. I recently found you know, this writing app. It is called the Cambridge Writing App. If you write on it, it will actually tell you the quality of the sentence, to which level it is suited, and it will give you marks also. Whether the sentence is very difficult to understand, how it can be rewritten, it will give you all the options. So technology has you know, grown amazingly, and you should also try these methods and try and understand. And usually when you are writing, give it to somebody, ask them to read, get feedback and write. Feedback works wonderfully when it comes to writing. That will be my tips for you. Thank you, Sharon, for being an active participant.
Thank you, Shobha ma'am. Probably once we get more questions, we will pass them on to you through your email. I think the students are very lucky today. Because they have got, you have been able to tell in such a student-friendly manner so that they are not worried also. Now I think they will have some clear idea about what they can really work on. Mm-hmm. So I think the participants, including all the colleagues in my department, all of us are very, very thankful to you for having thrown light on so many things by which English can open doors to employability. Thank you so much, Dr. Shobha.
Thank you, ma'am. Shweta has asked a question.
Shweta
is asking, what is the difference between fluency and accuracy? Now, before answering the question itself, I would like to highlight certain things. See, students, when we you know, go to conferences also, when we ask them to ask questions, most of them won't. But there will be always one or two students who will keep asking. Now, apparently, when we notice these students, you know, somehow they create a very positive impression on us. And when we meet them later, you know, in some stage, mostly when I go for interviews, I find these students, and you know, then I tell the whoever's recruiting them, I tell, I know this girl, she is really, you know, very active, and I have known this person already, and I kind of recommend that person also. Because you should understand that asking questions after a lecture, after, you know, a conference or speech, is creating a very positive impression on the person. Like I told you, improve, develop your social contacts. You have to develop your social contacts only like this. So you create that kind of a good impression, and then, you know, now supposing when I meet Sharon, I'll definitely remember. I'll say, okay, so you are the girl who are asking all the questions. So how is your writing going? I will definitely, you know, be able to ask her. So there is always a positive side to asking questions. So please feel free to, you know, ask questions, not just in this session, but in any session, because it will create that kind of visibility for you. Now coming to Shweta's question, fluency and accuracy. Fluency refers more to speaking without any kind of break, even though mistakes are there. Accuracy is mostly grammatical accuracy. So in the Indian context, when it comes to communication, most of us aim only for fluency, not so much for accuracy. Of course, the balance has to be created. Now, if I'm speaking fluently with a lot of mistakes, it will be like riding on a speed breaker for you. You are able to get the idea, but then it is like going on a speed breaker. Nobody wants to go on a bumpy speed breaker, right? So both have to be balanced. So that's the difference. Accuracy refers to the grammatical accuracy, and fluency refers to your strength in speaking, articulating well. Thank you, Shweta, for that question. Yes, Kavita, you can wrap up.
Yes,
ma'am. A graceful and warm evening to our most valued guests, our faculty, management committee, and most beloved students. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, on behalf of EFL department and the entire fraternity of the SRM IST, I extend my sincere thanks to all of you. My hearty thanks to our chief guest, who spared time for her in her busy schedule to grace the occasion. On behalf of our SRM committee and the audience, I thank our speaker, Dr. Shobha ma'am, for the day of the valuable information, whatever she shared with us in this present time. I thank everyone who joined with us today. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thanks for sparing with us today. Thank you so much. I thank each and everybody here. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you all. All the best to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am?
Yes, Savita.
Ma'am, Orim Shalayan. Rama, ma'am, should we end of this?
Yes, yes, avladha, avladha.
Yes, ma'am, thank you. Ma'am?
சார் ஒரு நிமிஷம் நீ கட் பண்ணு, நான் ஒரு நிமிஷம் லைன்ல வரேன். ரெக்கார்டிங் ஸ்டாப் பண்ண. ஹலோ, ரவி ரெக்கார்டிங் ஸ்டாப் பண்ணு அப்பதான் லிங்க் உனக்கு வரும் ஆமா நீ ரெக்கார்ட் ஸ்டாப் ரெக்கார்டிங் உனக்கு வந்து பாரு அது வரலையா
அது பழைய கேட்கும்போது எக்ஸாம்ஸ் வர